Hello, hello, and welcome back to Cities Skylines. We're still in the unnamed city. This is episode 5. Now, I just had a power cut. I was recording the episode. I was about 10 minutes in, and I didn't have a power cut. I moved my leg, and I yanked the cable out the back of my gaming PC. Today I learned that. Because I don't have a name in the city, the autosave mod doesn't actually save. It actually says it's saving, like packaging in the top right, but it's not actually saving, because the city doesn't have a name and the game doesn't save with no name. So yeah, so I just put a dot there, so now it does actually have a name, but this is still an unnamed city. I don't know why I'm running this whole unnamed thing, but meh. Anyway, let's have a look here. So there's the university, 850 students now. That's pretty good. I was gonna sort of keep an eye on these bus line here, because this is just the main bus route coming into this area. If I unpause the game here, traffic's not too bad coming into the city at the moment. I mean, there's a lot. It looks good, but it's moving. This roundabout is working very well. I do like this. As you can see, a lot of people going sort of this way, or moving in, new people. I think I can actually build a footpath like this. Will that go? I don't know. I don't think that'll work. I'm just going to come along here like that. And then I'm going to have a shop there. It's a bit of space there, a bit of unzoned land. And let's have a look. So we're still having this not enough educated workers problem. Looks like we're over capacity on schools. Let me just plonk another school down. High school is getting pretty close as well. So if I go and just increase the education budget a little bit, that should give me a load more school places. Yeah, you can see it jumped up there straight away. So yeah, that looks fine. I'll probably just get away with deleting this power line here. I've got a little bit of space here, so if I just put in a street, I think a street would be fine here. Well, let's have curvy roads, please. Come right up to the footpath there, and we'll just fill that in with so we'll have just a shop there and a shop there, and yeah. Oh no, I can't. I've got to remember that. You can't put shops on these roads because trucks can't get there, and then they'll never get any goods, and that would be bad. That would be very bad. Right, so shop there. Got to remember that. I think I could probably add a road in here. Heading to this new area here, you know, just in case any of the people that moved into, I know it's the university district, but some people might, you know, get a job in the industrial zone, whatever. So we'll extend this like that bit. We'll just add a little bit of industrial here. I think we've actually just cut off sewage. Luckily it's come straight back again, but I will just move this power line. Just so that doesn't happen, and you know, perhaps we'll just actually stick, this is the industrial zone, we'll just stick another incineration plant in here. And actually, look, we actually needed one. It's quite surprising, because I've already had three. The city is producing a lot of rubbish. As you can see, they're all moaning that the sewage is backing up, but you know, that should go away, because we've rebuilt the power lines. Yeah, it's all going away. Oh, look at this, a bit of traffic now, a little bit of traffic. Oh yeah, there's a lot of people moving through now. So I knew this sort of area here was going to be a problem eventually, just because of the volume of traffic moving through. And it's all start stop here, these junctions all so close to each other. It should be fine though. I might look at upgrading this to a free lane at some point, but it's good to see that the vehicles are using all the lanes, most of the lanes anyway. Yeah. People go straight ahead here. Alright, well, this junction's working perfectly. I remember we set this one up last game, so you know, I might want to look at creating a complex system going straight through here, maybe having all of these lights along this section of road green at the same time so people can get through. It would probably want to be upgraded to a free lane road as well, just so we can have some turning lanes. We can have a right turn lane here, and yeah, that would work. What I might do is just connect this road to here, and actually, make it one way. That just makes it a bit easier, because now this is just all straight. I don't want anything going up there. There were no bus lines going up there, so I could have done the opposite, and then we wouldn't have needed traffic lights at all. But actually, for people making a right turn here, they'd probably need traffic lights. And yeah, now I've done that, it's actually put traffic lights there, because I didn't have traffic lights here before. But this pretty much reinforces the fact that I'm going to need to set up a system here so that we don't have major traffic problems. Let's actually just make it all houses, shops along this bit. Like so. I'm gonna have this little bit here as shops as well, just at the end there. We'll have this one as a shop as well. Sorry, we could demolish that person's house, it's too bad. Alright, let's do this. I think first thing we've got to do is we've got to upgrade the road to a free lane. I don't think I'm going to go... If I go right to the roundabout, I'm going to have to redo all the lanes on the roundabout, which... Nah, should be fine. I'll pause the game to do this. Okay. And actually, I think, yeah, we'll go all the way. Now, there actually is going to be a lot of traffic going, making a right turn here. So if I now go to my lane manager, I mean, I think, although I could set this lane up to be green when this road is green for this direction, but actually, I don't think it's going to matter too much. This road here needs to be free lane. Okay, so this is one way here, so we don't need turning lanes here. Left turn only here? Yeah, sure. So if I go... Alright, we definitely want that lane like that. Trouble here is there going to be too many people in the middle lane? Possibly, but probably not. Probably not. Okay. So let's do this one now. So right turn only. This is where I wish that actually you were able to put more than, you know, for these junctions, I wish I could have four lanes here. I wish I could have two for straight on, one for right and one for left, but I can't. And I fear that I'm going to need at least two lanes to go straight ahead, even though it would be nice to, again, have left turn while this side's green, but it's not going to happen. It's not going to work. Right, that's one way. And how many people are going to be going left from this direction? Probably not that many, I wouldn't have thought. So yeah, we'll have it straight ahead as well as left turn. Here, we'll have right turn only. And then... like so. Let's do this one. So we want turning lane. And let's play. So it's gonna take the pathfinding a while to figure this out. Figure all these new routes out that I've just put in. So we'll get out of that window and we'll give it a bit of time. We'll see if the traffic clears up. Probably won't, but it might. So we'll just fast forward and watch things move along, if they move along at all. So there's actually a lot of people going left here, which actually is probably people moving into this new area, which is causing a fair amount of traffic here. Question is whether I can justify having a left turn only lane here. Possibly. There is a lot of people moving through. Yeah, the traffic's actually cleared up on its own. I still want to set up a complex system through here, but I will do it later on. So I just want to make sure the path findings worked out the lanes. A little bit of patience. Right. So our landfill's almost full. If I stick another incineration plant down, and actually we're just going to empty these landfills. We're going to get rid of them. So that's gonna put a lot of pressure on the... it's probably going to fill these incineration plants up straight away. So we'll let that happen. Ooh, no water. There we go, that should cheer them up. Right, we need some more shops. So, perhaps if I have just a few... few shops over here, as you know, just sort of going into the industrial zone, and I could probably want to run a bus route. Just straight from this sort of housing area here to this new industrial zone, and actually at some point we're going to want to build an office area, just an area with some offices in. And so yeah, we'll do that. Let's just fill in some of the space here. We've got a little bit of space. Bit of a windy road there, but that should be fine. So we'll just fill that in. We'll stick in a crosswalk there, and there's no point there. Just so people can use this for path and cross the road. And we have a small park. Well, actually, thinking about it, we don't have many cemeteries, do we? We've only got one. Yeah. So we've got two cemeteries in the city now. Because we haven't unlocked the body incinerator yet. Crematorium. I couldn't think of the word for it then. So that... I'm expecting a death wave soon, you know, loads of people to die. At the moment there's 20 dead bodies that I'm going to assume are going to need picking up. 25, that just jumped up from 20 to 25. So yeah, I guess the first settlers of the city are probably dying off now. I guess these red buildings are where bodies need picking up. So actually, quite a few of them are in the new area, but I guess people already living in the city moved house. So that makes sense. So I'm going to assume all the hearses are busy. Oops. No? Oh, okay. But then they pick up 10 borders at a time, don't they? So I guess they stop off in 10 different places. Oh, isn't that annoying when they change lanes like that? Are they all changing to the right lane? I wish they'd do that earlier. Oh well. Oh well. So yeah, right now everybody's sort of hogging the left lane. It is all people turning this way, isn't it? Change the let me change the lane here. It's just one lane to go straight on. It just doesn't quite make sense to me, but it might work. It might work out for the best. Wow, there's so many people going this way. This is a very busy road. If I put the traffic layer on. Which is this one. Yeah, it's a red road. Now once the Pathfinder figures out that I want this as a left lane only road, then maybe the traffic will sort of get better. But yeah, there's nobody going, not very many people going straight ahead here anymore. It's weird. And speed up. Oh yeah, I was going to do trains this episode. That's not going to happen. I haven't got time for that now. We'll just concentrate on our roads. Takes so long for it to work it out, doesn't it? Because I guess it's anything that's already spawned, and there's a lot of large traffic that's already spawned. Look. Use the other lane. Oh, what? It still says straight ahead. Sorry, it's here, isn't it? Yeah. It's like, stop going straight ahead. No. They will eventually. Give it time. But yeah, it's really backing up. Let's... just to allow it to clear. Go, go, go. Okay. Ah. All right, they're starting to change lanes, but they're doing it at the last minute, which is really bad. I really don't want them to do that. Please don't change it at the last minute. Should already be in the right lane. There you see, they're starting to change now. They're figuring it out, which is good. All right, there we go. See, now, as expected, the problem's going to be that there's too many people in the middle lane. God, they're all changing fucking lanes like lunatics. See, nobody's using the middle lane here. Idiots. Yeah, just say, you know what. Do it like that, maybe. Maybe that will work. Wait. Oh, for fuck's sake, what are they doing? What? Where is he going? Is. What the fuck? That's taking it to the next level, isn't it? It's just ridiculous. It's just backing up worse and worse, isn't it? I make sure the road isn't covered by the district here, and then stick a heavy traffic ban in Elizabeth Square. Oh, these people moaning about noise. Citizens are sick because it's noisy. We need another hospital. Well, we do. Well, we really do. Let's plonk a hospital down over here. There we go. Oh, we need another police station as well. There we go. Oh, they're still all using the fucking left lane. And then, last minute changing. Don't last minute change. Stop last minute changing, you bastards. Maybe I'll just try to get these lanes right. It's painful. It's sort of working now, though. Maybe no right turn here. No right turn here will work. Yeah, like I said, the trouble is there just aren't enough lanes at the junctions. There needs to be a way for me to add just an extra lane here. That would be great. Like I think it's roads in like America. I know it's in Grand Theft Auto. Like, this side of the road will change to two lanes, which will allow this road site, this junction, to have four turning lanes. Just have some GTA-style junctions, please. That would be nice. People going across like that. So yeah, it seems that even though I've set these roads up, people are changing lane at the last minute, and I really don't want that. So let's get rid of that, and yeah, straight ahead as well as left. All right, let's set this up. So select all of our nodes. Do we need to select that one? Probably not. We'll just do these three because these are really close together, so it's quite important that these are sort of synced. Alright, let's pause the game to do this. Alright, let's just set all to red, and you know, I like to control the pedestrians as well. Alright, let's just set up modes. So we got our turning lane set up. It's one way, so it doesn't matter. And then here, you know, we need to set this one up as well. Alright, so to start, also you're going to have straight on and left, straight on and left. You know, just straight on at this one. And straight on at this one as well. So we'll have that for a good 20. I think 22 should be fine. All right, then we'll have them all go red. I think we'll leave those ones green. Do we want to leave those ones green? No, we'll turn this one red as well. We'll have our turning lanes go. This one can go. Turning lanes. I think we'll give the turning lanes 8 seconds, 8 ticks. And then if I send that one, can go red, and these could go green. That one for 8, and then we'll swap it around. We may as well have this lot going, that could stay, and then this side, and we'll stop for pedestrians. And we'll give the pedestrians 3 seconds. Alright, so we'll see how that goes. Show counters. Make sure everything's in order. So I'm really not expecting very much traffic on this road at all. So the green light time on this road is just trivial. It doesn't matter. And you know, these turning lanes, there isn't much traffic in them. So 8 seconds is more than enough. I could even potentially reduce that, because it's this road here that's got the longest wait time of 16 seconds. See, I'm thinking it's too long. There's actually a lot of stuff waiting here, so actually, if I swap these two rounds, because it looked like there was more traffic on this one, and then this one, maybe just 4. And we'll skip to that one. Just to keep an eye on it. Make sure that they've got enough time to move. Because I think this particular side is not got enough time. Potentially. Maybe. Alright, and we're straight back to green. Let's keep an eye on it. It's again, it's everybody in the left lane, and I'm trying to get it so they use the other lanes, but yeah. I'll see if I can figure it out off camera. I think we're out of time here, so thank you very much for watching. It's been quite a boring one, actually. I'm not gonna lie. Setting this roads up, I'll see if I can get it perfected for the next one. But thanks very much for watching. Do like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you next time.